Good day. My name is Alex Tursky. I'm the founder of Easy Travel. I'm going to present you the business model behind the totally free service of Easy Travel. But my story starts with the Get Your Guide platform, which helps tourists to meet human guides. In 2018, Get Your Guide attracted 17 million euro from investors on top of the previous 100 million. It's not alone. The top five platforms attracted 1 billion already, which indicates investors' expectations. Indeed, experts evaluate the local experience market above 100 billion. By now, it's above 10% of the travel market and it's growing very fast. Researchers report that this growth is boosted by the trend in demand of travelers to individually explore new and less popular places. These Meet Your Guide platform businesses look pretty much entrenched and well done. What can we improve here? Actually, we can expand it in very many directions. We start with a simple idea. We automate it. With Easy Travel, your smartphone guides you and triggers the right story in the right place in your language, both in the streets and in museums, globally. The stories are reused many times when a traveler gets to the right location. It's convenient and simple. Of course, we also have a platform behind the app to allow thousands of storytellers, museums, publishers to upload their stories. This is a map of our guided tours. There are 10,000 of them already around the globe, including 2,000 museums in 100 countries in 50 languages. And every day, new tours are published. Millions of travelers use our service because we are free. This graph represents content usage growth. You can see it doubles every year organically. So, while human guide platforms like Get Your Guide serve only a fraction of tourists who can pay 50 euro per excursion, with our free mobile guided tours, we serve the rest people on the move. It's called the long tail. But why free? Well, take YouTube, Instagram, etc. You would never know them if they're not free. Being free is mandatory for content platforms. If you are, you get to the next round where only one or two platforms take it all. Therefore, being the number one is the key success factor. And we are the number one. Our competitors don't follow that rule and they are 100 times behind us. Not a chance. So, who pays for the entertainment if not the end users? First, museums and tourist authorities. They attract more people with guided tours. Then, corporate sponsors who care for social impact they do. And finally, cultural, public and private funds. Mobile guided tours are a perfect solution for them as investments in content outlive any technology. Don't underestimate them. These guys invest billions in cultural projects and they will become a serious source of revenues for storytellers, just like they are for museums. For example, European public spending on culture are well above 100 billions per year. You notice, again we are talking about 100 billions, but just from another source. But how exactly tourist authorities, corporations and funds can leverage creativity of million storytellers? How can they distribute millions of microgrants without spending half of them on administration and quality control? We have a great solution for them called Storytelling as a Service, or STAS. It reminds the Spotify model. Remember, Spotify gets money from all subscribers and distributes it to performers, pro rata to their usage. The STAS is similar, but it's the cities, corporations and funds which will pay for the show, not people. Here's an example. A city decides to invest 50,000 euro into mobile guided tours. They can order 10 guided tours for 20,000 and spend the rest on administration and promotion. Or they can pay the same 50,000 to the best performing storytellers, who create the tours on their own expense, on monthly basis. Knowing the statistics, we can distribute the payments based on the factual usage. It will lead to competition between storytellers and as a result, more guided tours, more promotion and more usage. We will charge for the service, and we estimate this market to be at least a quarter of a billion euro for us. Another dimension to expand the market is to allow global services to benefit from the same tools using our content through API. For example, a car infotainment system may turn a boring highway trip into an exciting adventure, especially when self-driving cars get into the scene. Systems like Booking.com can use attractive guided tours to increase the amount of bookings. Apple Siri will tell stories while walking with you to keep you connected and to advertise places around. We have already started it. For example, our tours are available in Maps.me, the most popular offline map. And the Russian sister of Siri, Yandex Alice, already tells our stories in top museums. And here is the second business model. All these services will pay us for our stories, just like many apps pay for Google Maps above a certain threshold. Our estimation of the revenue cap at least 100 million. Let's sum it up. The automated guidance services will not replace human guides, but will expand it like movies expanded theater or records expanded live music markets. And we expand far beyond the limits of the human guide platforms. On the user side, we saw the long tail of all people on the move. It will be free and available at every corner. By the way, free doesn't mean bad quality. Quite opposite. Teams of professionals will outperform individual human guides, for sure. Voice-based assistants will learn to deliver it in a conversational mode, with our help. People get used to follow great stories on daily basis. On the supply side, we extended it from just human guides to museums, universities, publishers, and millions of individual storytellers. It's the real crowdsourcing. We found a sustainable way for all the storytellers to get compensated. Even more, we introduced a powerful promotion for their guided tours via all kinds of travel services, from TripAdvisor to upcoming technologies like Siri or self-driving cars. They'll be happy to get profit from storytelling. So, we invite all the stakeholders and make them happy, providing a sustainable win-win ecosystem for all. Please note that all of them are interested in massive usage, which could be reached only with automated and free guided tours. If such a need exists, somebody will do it. At the moment, we are just the first candidate. And finally, we know how to generate revenue on every stage of the value chain. On the supply side, we will earn on funds and cities, providing them with the STARS service. And we earn on mobile apps and services which use our content via API. In fact, we have more models here, but they're less important. What is important, we are building a new media. The media for people on the move. The YouTube was invented for people who sit and watch. We are just the next generation for people who go and listen. So, welcome to the experience economy. Please don't forget to install and try our mobile app. Not to learn how it works, but to learn how it feels.